We subtitled this Diginar, Thoughts on New Days and New Ways for Society, Consumers and Brands. Over the last 120 minutes, we've heard a wide range of views and persuasions from our expert contributors as to how the world might be moving forward in the coming months and years. Many ideas for much food for thought. What we did, essentially shutting down most of our modern world for 2 months, had never been tried before. However well or badly it turns out, we'll look back on the global lockdown with certain wonder. We should learn so much. How intertwined and interconnected the world economy is. How shadowy thin are everyone's profit margins. How dependent we all are on human traffic. Just ask the millions who work in shops, restaurants, hotels, airlines, bars, cafes, cinemas, and theatres. How we've built a global economy so reliant on ever-increasing consumption, where high-speed bandwidth is not a need but a basic human right. Because with no connectivity, we're creating another type of poverty, digital bandwidth poverty. But some of the most important things we learned were internal. When we weren't working or caring for our children and elderly relatives, introspection came knocking and settled in. Many of us conducted rough and ready life reviews, thinking about paths not taken, strokes of luck handed out to us. We made longer phone and video calls, talked of love more often and more easily. We cheered and applauded those keeping our hospitals and towns going. We redefined essential and what's truly important to us. We got pared down by our leaders, and now we're paring ourselves down. Look at the front cover of the July issue of American Vogue. No celebrity, no glitz, no high fashion. Just a pure rose, minimal and beautiful. A symbol of the larger issues in life. Nature, renewal, simplicity. Recently, George Will wrote, "The future has a way of arriving unannounced." Well, it certainly has, and now we're having to recalibrate politically, economically, socially. We have to fast forward our thinking, our behaviours, our strategies to keep up with an unexpected future that's already here. Being human, we'll embrace change, and we won't simply adapt to our new circumstances. We'll make unexpected and undreamt of advances because mankind is infinitely resourceful. We're endlessly inventive, daring, experimental, and, when needs must, revolutionary. I believe we all share a huge responsibility in the months and years ahead. We cannot, must not, let our recent collective experience, the tragedy and the hardship that COVID-19 inflicted on us, be for nothing. We owe it to those that cannot tell the tale. It's time to work at providing a better life for all. It's time maybe to live in a world of simpler, plainer values. Deepak Chopra said, "All great changes are preceded by chaos." Well, we've certainly had the chaos. Now let's work on the great changes. As it says in the Talmud, "If I'm not for myself, then who will be for me? And if I'm only for myself, then what am I? And if not now, when?"